Demonstrators are once again protesting outside the town hall today about both the proposed housing development at Redwood Brook and the controversial East London bypass link. And finally, travel news in the area. There's problems yet again on the B1499 with traffic turning back over 2 miles from the motorway junction there, so avoid that area if you can. You're listening to Tomo's Breakfast.
Morning,
Dad.
Morning, Sharon. Coffee?
Oh, yes, please.
Of love. It's summer.
Has it both been?
Not yet.
Hey, T, come on, breakfast. What are you up to today?
I thought I might drive over and visit Bertie, air the car.
Katie, hurry up.
Or I might just wander around town centre.
What is she doing?
Or I might even form my own pop group, OAP Zone.
Good idea.
Or then again, I might dress up as an 8-foot chicken and chase people up the street.
Great. Molly. Can you get Say Day for me today, Granddad?
Yes, if I go to town.
Thanks.
What's up with that brother of yours?
I see, upstairs on the phone.
Anything the matter?
Credit card bill.
Oh, dear.
It's ridiculous. We haven't even had a holiday this year, and look at all the money pouring out of the house.
Well, can't you ask Dad for some?
Your father's too busy building the nest with his new love until he gets bored of that responsibility too.
Sharon, isn't there anything we can cut back on?
You tell me. Sorry, I didn't mean to shout.
That's okay. Sorry about mentioning Dad.
He's still your father.
Been guys left us stranded.
I'm afraid so. He pays maintenance, but that goes nowhere.
I really miss him.
I know. You got me and your granddad and your brother.
I know.
What have you been doing, Paul?
I've just done half a mile.
Don't be ridiculous. It's not that far from the bedroom.
On the exercise bike.
I'm going to get my car fixed.
Oh, thanks, Laura.
That gearbox is hanging on by a thread.
Why can't you do it?
Because I'm going to visit Marina today and I won't have time.
Well, she lives in town. Can't you drop it on the way?
What? And walk from the garage to hers? It's over a mile, Paul. How long's your mother staying for?
Oh, wait until the decorators have finished her flat. Why? What's she done now?
Breathe. Where is she?
Oh, she says, could you take hers up to her?
Honestly? What did her last slave die of?
Doing a mile on the exercise bike.
That was Summer in the City, the adventure from Soldier of Love. You're listening to Tom O's Breakfast Bonanza. And today's weather has been forecast as highly changeable. Another typical English spring day.
Are you enjoying that, Grandad?
Very interesting, Katie.
Yeah, right.
Sean!
He's still on the phone.
That's one thing that can be cut right back.
I'm not deaf.
No, but we'd save on the phone bill if you were.
Oh, shut up, Katie.
If we can cut the phone bill down by at least £20, that would help.
Phone you organising playing squash tonight.
And why does Simon never phone you?
He does.
His mum's a right-out bag and she won't let him.
That's enough, Katie.
Sharon, do you realise that half of your bill is spent on petrol?
Good grief. You're right.
Well, don't blame me. I can't drive.
No, but you're always getting lifts into town.
Oh, yeah. Say so you get chauffeured to the sports hall 4 times a week.
It's 5 miles away.
Get a bike.
You get a bike.
Just stop it. We're all going to have to cut back, all of us. Until Sean starts work, there's only one wage coming into the house.
I could get a part-time job.
No, Dad, I wasn't having a go at you.
Well, there's loads of vacancies at the supermarket.
I can always work there for a few hours a week.
Dad, you're retired. And what about your back?
Suppose so.
No. It's the petrol that's costing too much.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying that as from today, we're cutting right back on car usage.
There you are, Pam.
What's that?
It's an ironing board. What do you think it is?
There's no need to be sarcastic.
How long is it going to be before your flat's ready?
I don't know. It could be at least another week.
Wonderful.
What was that racket I heard earlier?
There's Paul on the exercise bike.
He'll need to do more than that if he wants to shift his flab.
Oh, he's trying very hard.
What, by eating a fried breakfast and driving to the train station? If he walks down the alleyway, he'll get there in 10 minutes.
Well, he has to catch the 8:35.
He has to shift his...
Pam! Do you mind?
Well, he spends £5 on the car park, gets blood pressure driving in the traffic. It's just as easy to walk.
Do you have to go on?
More coffee?
So, Sharon, what do you suggest?
Well, we can start to walk instead of depend on the car. Sean, you're going to have to start getting the bus to the sports hall.
What bus?
Well, you have to look it up and find out.
Where?
You're taking 4 A-levels. I'm sure you have the intelligence to find a bus route.
4 A-levels, yet no common sense.
What is it with you?
And you can start by walking to your friends and cutting down on the number of visits into the town centre.
Oh, but I like going into the town centre.
Well, like doesn't pay the bills.
And I suppose I should start walking into town too.
So what's the point of having 2 cars?
Your granddad has worked hard all his life to afford a few luxuries.
Yeah, well, I thought we was broke and we had to cut back on luxuries.
Don't be so rude.
Well, why me and Sean got suffer?
I'll leave it, Katie.
No, I won't. It's my social life going down the pan. Because we've got 2 cars sitting on the drive.
Come back here and apologise.
Oh, leave her. You've threatened her independence. Children don't like that. And she's right, you know. Do we really need 2 cars?
Anyway, I'm going to get ready for college.
And it would do my back good to walk.
Jamie, Zoe, breakfast, come on!
Where are you going?
Out.
Three cheers.
Morning, my sweethearts.
See you later, Gran.
Bye, darling.
You'll be here later, won't you?
Of course. You won't get rid of me that easily.
I'll be late now. Ta-da, love.
Bye.
Ta-da, Mum.
Bye.
I think your mum's ready to take you to school.
Sorry about what I said earlier.
Oh, that's okay. Part of what you said was right. I rarely use the car. It's not fair if saving money means you don't see your friends, but I get to keep the car.
But it shows at the end of the day.
But it is expensive to keep.
Katie! Sean! Come on! I'm leaving in 2 minutes. I've got to be in work early today.
Come in.
I think I'll walk into town today. Do me some good. Get some fresh air. Want me to get that record for you?
C-Day, Grandad. Remember to ask for a C-Day.
Right. C-D.
Here. That's the title and the group. Here.
Right.
See you later.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
Get my new car tomorrow.
Nice.
Do you want to lift them?
No, thanks, love. I'm too busy proving a point.
All right. Suit yourself.
Off you go.
Jamie, Zoe, hurry up!
Hi, Marina. Look, I'm just checking we're still on for today. No, great. No, I'm really looking forward to it. Got plenty of money to spend. I'll see you at the coffee shop. Okay, we're on our way. See you there. Bye. Come on, you two.
Come on, you idiot, I've got a train to catch.
Well, here we go, legs. And we leave the car at home. Best foot forward.
Selfish. I beg your pardon. You lot, you drive like maniacs. 6 times I've nearly been knocked down trying to cross that road.
I can assure you it wasn't me.
And just look at the way you park all over the place. You've blocked the traffic, you're in front of the school, and the worst thing of all is you leave your engine running while you're gas-bagging to your friends.
Happy now? Who exactly do you think you are?
A very annoyed resident of this road who is sick to death of parents driving their children down in convoy in huge tanks.
I really don't think this is any of your business.
What's wrong, Mum?
Don't worry, sweetheart. Look, whoever you are, I am sorry that you've had a rough deal with the traffic, but you're upsetting my children. Now think of them.
That is exactly what I am doing. It would do them good to walk the 3 minutes down from one end of the road to the other.
I like walking.
Be quiet. Go on, off to school. Now, quickly. Now, if you thought of yourself a little less, you might consider your children and the environment, and heaven forbid, the rest of society. Well, really?
What have I done to deserve this today?
Jogging.
Mum, what are you doing here?
Well, believe it or not, dear, I'm actually going to buy a train ticket to go shopping in London.
Well, why didn't you get a lift here with me?
No, thanks. I've seen the way you drive. And your language in that car, honestly, I think it's that wife of yours leading you into bad ways.
But it would have saved you the walk.
Says Mr. Keep Fit. Anyway, I like the walk. Not being stuck in some box with exhaust fumes being pumped up my nose.
Oh, right. So you won't want to lift home later on, then?
No, I enjoy proving a point.
Oh, it's a shame, innit? Especially as they forecast rain later on. Oh, well, never mind. You'll just have to get soaked, won't you?
No, I won't, Mr. Clever Dick. Because with the money I saved from the car parking fees, I bought myself an umbrella and a packet of Rolos. Oh, look, it's my last one. Excuse me, love. Return ticket to Liverpool Street, please.
Switch your phone on, Marina.
Hello, Laura. Everything okay?
Oh, Alistair, you won't believe it.
What's wrong?
The gearbox in my car is finally gone.
Oh, dear. Expensive job.
I'm supposed to be meeting my friend Marina in East London in an hour.
Can't you call her?
I've tried. She's already left.
Is she a mobile?
Not switched on. I mean, I can't just leave her standing there.
I'd offer to take you there, but I'm going the opposite way.
Well, that's very sweet of you, Alistair.
What will you do?
Well, I'll just have to walk home. I've left the number of the breakdown recovery service there.
Well, good luck.
Well, hope your day's better than mine. Bye.
Goodbye.
Flipping traffic.
You're going to be late for your first lesson.
Look, things with money really that bad?
Well, yes, a few of the luxuries will have to go.
How else can we save on petrol?
I don't know.
What about getting food shopping locally? There's that all-night store, 5-minute walk away.
Have you seen the price of the food? It's much more expensive than the supermarket.
Yeah, but you do tend to hop in the car and drive all that way for a few silly little items.
Like what?
The bread.
Well, I like their own brand.
You said about cutting back, and I'm only trying to help.
Yeah, I know.
Shall I look for part-time work?
No, you concentrate on your A-levels. Your exams are soon.
I can work at the weekends.
You'll need to revise then.
Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, I'm off. Oh, and it'll do you good walking to the shops.
What do you mean?
Burns off fat walking.
Cheek, get inside.
See you later.
2 hours. Can't you get a rescue vehicle out any sooner? Right, well, I'll just have to call you this evening. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Now, what am I going to do?
Yes, I think what, I...
Would you like me to go in with you?
Well,
I'll take care of you. Don't worry, there's nothing to fear. There you are. You see, I told you there was nothing to fear.
So I see.
As I asked you to them. Well, it is now stuck outside the school. Yes, I know you work in London. Well, of
course it's going to kill me to get a bus. I mean, I have to sit next to undesirables. I am not a snob.
Right, that's it. I'll just talk to you later.
I am not a snob. Get a bus. How am I going to do this in that completely unpredictable weather?
Mr. Riser. He'll know.
Mr. Riser? Mr. Riser? Ah,
good morning, Laura.
Sorry to bother you, but I'm in need of some advice.
Oh, far away. The lavender can wait. It's such a patient plant.
Well, I know it may sound silly, but I need to get a bus. And I've no idea where to start.
Oh, you need the bus timetables.
Well, exactly, but where do I find that information?
I suggest you try Yellow Pages.
Perfect. Thank you.
I believe you live down my road.
Oh, do I?
Yeah. I've seen you drive past.
Oh, well, I'm afraid I haven't seen you.
Well, I'm not offended. It's just nice to have someone one's own age to chat to.
Yes, I don't get to meet all that many people locally.
Well, will you, if you drive everywhere?
No. May I ask your name?
Mrs. Shawcross. Oh, but you can call me Angela.
Oh, thank you. Mrs., you said?
Oh, yes, but my husband's been dead for several years. Hence my need to walk everywhere.
Ah, to keep the grieving mind occupied.
No, I just never learnt to drive.
Oh, I see.
And you are?
Oh, I'm Alistair Singleton.
Oh, what a lovely name. You sound like a lawyer.
Well, actually, I was in the army, you know.
Really?
Well, this way, is it?
Yes, yeah. Down here.
Stop for barking.
Yeah, should be along in a minute.
Right. How long does it take to get there?
Well, about 20, 25 minutes.
Not too long. Do they run quite regularly?
Yeah, like about every 10 minutes, so it should be one or two in a second. So.
Did you hear the way that woman went on at Mum this morning?
I know, to talk about embarrassing.
She did have a point.
What do you mean?
Why do we drive down the road to school? I mean, by the time Mum fusses about the car, manages to reverse out and then find a parking space, I bet we could have already walked there.
I know. I hate driving in summer, although it does save getting wet and cold in the winter.
Why don't we find out ways to stop using the car?
What, us?
Yeah, why not?
You're hardly going to stop the whole world from using cars.
I'm not talking about the whole world, I'm talking about us.
What, just our family?
Yeah, I mean, Mum's always going on about how unfit Dad is.
Yeah, and it would help to reduce pollution too.
Then let's do it.
Right.
So where do we start? So what can we do?
So much for saving the world.
I know. Let's start by cutting down the traffic outside the school.
How?
There must be someone we can turn to for help.
Hey, I've got it. I know someone.
Who?
Mr. Riser, our neighbour over the road.
Of course. He's worked on pollution control for years.
He still does.
He's always got some mad experiment going on in his shed.
Right. That's decided. After school, we go and get some advice from Mr. Riser.
Do you mind?
No, not at all.
Lovely day.
Yes, I love travelling in this weather.
Going anywhere nice?
Off to visit a friend in East London. You?
Going to work. Shift work, unfortunately.
Needs to get an eye in. That wretched car broke down, which is why I have to take the bus.
What happened to yours?
Oh, what, sorry?
Your car.
Oh, I don't have one.
Really?
I suppose they can be quite expensive.
Well, it's not the cost, it's just easier to use public transport.
You think so?
Well, it is for me. See, I've got limited parking where I live with no driveway. There's always a battle to find a space. And driving to town is always a nightmare.
My husband's always complaining.
complaining about the traffic. Now I just walk 5 minutes to stop, get on the bus, sit back and let the driver do the worrying. Don't they always turn up late and get stuck in traffic? No, they're usually on time. And with bus lanes, they whiz past all the other cars. But what if you stay out late? What if I go clubbing, me and my mate share a taxi? Cost next to nothing. I'm afraid I'm too used to the convenience and comfort of my car. Just have to learn to adapt. Most towns can't deal with cars. Oh, this is my stop coming up. Have a good day. Bye.
Yes, well, this is my company and I make those sort of decisions. Is that understood? Yes. Thank you. Now, come in, Paul. I want a word with you, please. As our finance manager, I want you to look into ways of reducing the amount my company is spending.
All right. Any particular areas you're thinking of?
Yes, well, I've been looking into the company's expenditure lately and I've discovered one or two rather interesting facts.
Such as?
Meals out with clients.
Oh.
Yes. Ah. A little more stringency there, I think, especially with Roberta Shankworth, who seems to consider it necessary to quaff 6 bottles of red wine on every occasion.
All right. I'll mention it and lay down some guidelines. Anything else?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, just a little indigestion. Bit of a rushed breakfast this morning, I'm afraid. I seem to have to leave another 5 minutes earlier every week just to miss the traffic into London.
Yeah, so I get a train. I can't bear all that stress.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, where I live doesn't have a particularly good rail link. And it's a half hour's drive from the station. It's all rather annoying.
Doesn't Sally in marketing come in from your direction?
Oh, I don't know, does she?
Yeah, I'm sure she does. Maybe she can give you some advice. I know she gets a train. Are you sure you're okay?
Yes. Yes. And that brings me very nicely to my second point. Oh, blast. Hello, Jonathan Pike.
What a racket.
Rather enjoying it.
I tell you, Angela, the music in those shops gets louder every time I go in.
No, Alistair, I think we just get less tolerant.
You're probably right. I must say, though, the town centre's marvellous for shopping in now. It's all been pedestrianised.
Oh, definitely. I mean, who wants to be splattered by a 10-ton lorry when you're rushing to get a bargain from Boots?
Quite. Shall we have a little sit-down?
Oh, yes.
Tell you what, Angela, why don't we walk back by Meadow Lane?
Down there?
It's been years since I strolled down that leafy walkway, the bird song in my ear, the gentle summer breeze ruffling my shiny blonde hair.
When was that?
I was courting Elsie Witherslack at the time, and we strolled arm in arm down Meadow Lane, not a care in the world. The busy sound of the chirping of the crickets in the summer fields that flanked our meander, our constant countryside companion. This way, Angela.
Mom? Hi, look, I'm going to the sports centre this afternoon. No, I've got no lessons. What saves me coming all the way home and then travelling back out again?
Do you want me to pick you up and take you? I've still got 40 minutes of my lunch left.
I thought we were trying to save money. Don't worry, I'll go by bus.
Well, be careful. Do you know where you're going?
Mum, I'll be fine. I'm 18. One of the canteen staff told me which bus to take. He lives up that way.
Well, okay. Be careful.
See you later.
Mum, I've had a brilliant idea on how to save money.
I think it was a little longer ago than you realised.
I think you may be right.
The major link to the motorway now.
Not a cricket, not a bird, not a bee.
The only bee around here is the road itself.
Yes, the B1499. Doesn't have the same ring to it as Meadow Lane.
The world is changing, Alistair.
So, how do we get across?
With difficulty. By the way, whatever happened to Elsie Witherslap?
Married early, Colin. Cummings and became a traffic warden.
Happy escape all round!
Well, don't keep me in suspense. What is this brilliant idea? You've been prancing around all smug for 20 minutes.
I've got to buy to help to cut back on using the car.
Which is?
Well, you know you said you didn't want to drive me into town anymore.
Yes.
And I still want to go into town.
So?
I'm going to buy a bike.
What?
Well, then I can cycle into town.
Oh, yes, of course I will, dear. Yes. Have I ever let you down, love? Yeah, well, apart from that. Yeah, all right. Bye, dear. Yep. Bye, pudding. One thing after another.
Problems?
Yeah. Someone's reversed into my wife's car.
Oh, no.
Worse than that, they drove off.
You're joking?
No.
Where's this, a home?
No, multi-story car park. Oh, it never rains, but it pours. She's got scratches all over her. And she had a beautiful bodywork.
Your wife?
The car. Oh, she's all right. She's giving me a hard time about it.
Oh. Are you sure you're okay, Mr. Pike?
Yeah. Go and check. Sit down. Oh. Jason, I'll get me some indigestion tablets from the shops, will you, and bring them in? Oh, and get me a fried egg sandwich as well, with sauce. Oh, and some chips if you happen to pass a chip shop. No, I think I'll pass on the Mars bar today. Got to eat healthily and all that. Thank you. Jason, I think I will have that Mars bar after all. Oh, and get a receipt. I'll put it through the business. Thank you. Now then, where were we?
Reducing expenses.
Yeah, moving swiftly on. The second issue is we are spending far too much on travel expenses and company cars.
Yeah, but the salesmen need their cars to get to meetings.
Oh, yeah. You tell me exactly how much we are spending every year keeping five cars on the road.
No.
But why?
I said no, and I mean no.
That's not a reason. That's just you treating me like a kid.
Exactly. Katie, you're 14.
I'm talking about riding a bike into town to save us all money. Stop having to ask you for a lift every 5 minutes.
You'll just have to ask your friends over here.
Oh, yeah, they're going to really want to come all the way down here to sit in our back garden. Be watched over by you and told off because we laugh too loud.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Why should all my friends come down here to make you happy? We meet in town. We always meet in town. And they're going to keep on meeting in town.
Then you'll just have to find something else to do.
No, I won't.
You are not cycling into town.
Okay, give me one good reason.
I've got several, and you'll just do as you're told.
You are so two-faced. Dad had to let me. I wish I'd gone to live with him.
You look absolutely exhausted.
You are a shopaholic. How on earth do you put up with her?
By ignoring her, mostly.
Oi, cheek! Go and put the kettle on.
Okay. 13. Can't believe it.
Seems like only last year I was that age.
You don't have to remind me.
Still looking forward to the move on the 16th?
Yep. I still can't believe we got 90,000 for this place.
Well, centre of town. Very desirable for some.
Tea or coffee, Laura?
Tea. One sugar, please.
I'll have a coffee, thanks.
Can I have an apple?
Yes. Remember, you've got to be back at school in 20 minutes.
Okay.
So, still pleased you're leaving town, eh?
Absolutely. I mean, listen to the traffic out there. Some nights I can hardly sleep. And the speed they go down the road, it terrifies me every time I step out the front door.
It could be lovely to have you near.
The roads around this part of town was designed for carts and horses, not juggernauts.
It has got worse, even in the 10 years you've been here.
It's about time they built that bypass.
So, how is Antonio about moving to our new school?
Not happy, but we'll chat about it when she goes back to school.
I thought you might like to try some of my elderflower wine that's finally brewed.
Oh, I think the whole street's been looking forward to this.
The secret is patience and understanding, as with most things in life.
If only it were that simple.
Problems.
You don't want to know.
Well, I can always be persuaded to sample a cup of Earl Grey tea.
You don't mind?
These ears were made for bending.
Come in. I'll put the kettle on.
So, what's happening with the bypass?
Protesters causing problems.
Mind you, when you see what they rip up to lay down roads, it does make you feel very guilty.
But they're not the ones that have to live with this horrendous traffic. We've had so many accidents down this road, it's untrue.
Well, wasn't that young lad killed around here?
Yeah, some idiot of a lorry driver decided to overtake the traffic and ploughed head-on into his car.
It's terrible.
He was only 18.
Mind you, the protesters are saying that we should transfer freight to rail and keep large cargo off the roads.
Yeah, but you've got to have an extensive rail network for that. And then you've still got to get the goods from the track to the point where they have to be delivered in the towns.
Well, there must be some answer to it.
Antonia? Baby,
I'm here. Oh, no. What's going on?
Oh, are you all right?
Oh, she'll be all right, she'll be all right. Biscuit?
No, thank you.
So, you see my dilemma?
Mm. Yes, indeed. Well, the first thing is, if Katie is going to cycle into town, that she has a decent bike in proper working order, you know, with good brakes.
It's not that that worries me.
Oh, I know, that is my second point. A personal safety.
Exactly.
Well, she'll have to wear a cycle helmet and reflective strips if it's dark, and keep where possible to cycle routes. There are quite a few in the town now.
Am I being overprotective?
Cycling, like any form of transport, is not without its dangers. But with a bit of thought and as many precautions in place, it should be fine. And she is 14.
I worry enough about Sean getting the bus into town.
Oh, but it's good that they're willing to try alternative forms of transport.
True. I'm sorry to have gone on.
Not at all. It's nice to see a parent that cares.
So, what can I do?
At this stage, talk to her.
Are you okay?
Relax and just sit back, okay?
Didn't know you had asthma.
Yeah, it's only come on over the past year.
Well, what caused it?
Difficult to say. But I think it's got to do with all that traffic fumes.
Do you reckon?
Haven't you noticed a difference in air quality from where you live to here?
Yes, but then this is a town.
Exactly. Well, I'm not taking any more risk with Antonia's health. I tell you, Laura, the 16th can't come quick enough.
Can I come in?
Me too. I don't want us to fall out over this.
Well, neither do I.
I'm pleased you're thinking of your health.
And of saving our money.
I was thinking of your safety.
Mum, I'm no more likely to be attacked or murdered because I've ridden into town on a bike.
I'm more concerned that you cycle safely and take care on the roads. You know how busy they can get in town? Half the people drive like maniacs.
I know, and I'll be careful. And I can call you once I've got into town.
Look, you'd better get back to school. We can chat about it properly later.
Okay.
Are you sure you're okay?
I'm fine, honestly.
Okay. Well, you go and lie down for half an hour, and I'll write a note explaining why you're late for school. Do you still want the tea?
Oh, yes.
You see why I want to leave?
Well, I really hope that living where I do helps ease her asthma. It's a terrible thing for a girl her age, just when she's starting to grow up properly.
10 years has made all the difference to this street. And I don't want to wait around whilst everybody decides whether they're ever going to build that bypass or not.
Well, that's understandable.
I don't want to knock on my door one day and it's a policeman standing there telling me that's my child that's been knocked over by a lorry mounting the pavement. Or some irate driver decides to drive at 50 miles an hour going down my street.
Still, in 2 weeks' time you'll be just down the end of the road from me, away from all this hassle.
Can't wait. Oh, well, as a kettle's boiling, I better go write that note.
I better find out what time the buses go back. Gotta pick up the children at 3:30.
Well, this is my stop.
Oh, at least I know where you live now.
Yes. Oh, would you like to come in for a cup of tea?
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't. I'm afraid I have to get back. I'm organising a committee meeting for the protest against the bypass.
Oh, were you involved with all that?
Oh, absolutely. There should be more money spent on public transport and alternative methods of travel instead of this mindless digging up of the countryside and laying roads.
Yes, I can understand that, seeing as what's happened to Meadow Lane.
There'll be no countryside left around here soon. It'll be all tarmac.
Well, I wish you luck.
I protested up a tree last year.
Did you indeed? You know, I don't think I can keep up with you.
Oh, Alistair, don't be so old. I'll tell you what. Why don't we go for a nice long walk down by the river tomorrow?
Yes, that'll be lovely.
Good. I'll pick you up at 10 o'clock then.
Fine. Well, 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 Alistair. So there's life in this old dog yet.
Well, it is rather a lot.
Yeah. Well, what with car taxes, petrol prices, and servicing, you're just throwing money down the drain.
You can't expect the entire sales team to go there by train, can you?
Why not?
Well, time for one thing.
They'll have accurate train timetables and no excuse for being late due to traffic.
To be honest with you, Mr. Pike, a company car is a perk of the job and the comfort of travelling door to door.
Something has got to give, Paul. We're losing money left, right and centre. If we don't tighten our belts soon, the future does not look good. And I'm told the Tokyo is very unpleasant.
I'll come up with a strategy to reduce our travel expenses then.
No, not reduce, Paul. Halve.
As you say, Mr. Pike. Halve.
I look forward to receiving your proposal on Monday morning. Thank you, Paul.
Thank you.
for them.
Well, it's worth a bit more than that, I hope.
You're thinking of selling your car?
Funny you should say that.
Well, you don't really use it that much, do you?
No. And walking certainly does have its advantages.
Oh, yes. What have you been up to?
I was picked up today.
Oh, you're a dark horse.
Yes, a rather charming woman called Angela.
Angela Shawcross, the road protester.
You know her?
Oh, yes. Oh, only in the environmental sense. Well, you certainly got your hands full there. She has a lot of spirit.
Indeed.
Well, you must be smitten if you're already giving up your car.
Oh, no, that was already on the cards. We've had to economize since Sharon's husband walked out.
No, it can't be easy.
It's just that I'd feel rather lost without my car.
What do you use it for?
Oh, mainly to go into town. Once a month, I go to visit my friend Bertie in Clapham.
Well, the town centre and Clapham are quite easy to get to from here.
It's just the comfort of the car.
Just think what you're paying, huh? Car tax, MOT, insurance, repair bills, petrol, oil servicing, you work it all out. You could afford to go on a train first class to see your mate in Clapham.
Oh, I think I'll take early retirement. I'll become a deck chair attendant. Something where there's no more stress. Jason, would you go out and bring me a burger in, please? No, I think I'll have a healthy drink today. Clear mineral water. Yeah. Jason, can I change that drink order? Bring me a Coke instead, yeah. Thank you. Oh, roll on the weekend. Oh.
It's just as you get older, there's more security in a car.
Oh, but there may come a time where you can't drive.
Well, I'm not that old.
But what if your eyesight goes or your back gets too bad?
It does get harder to drive as you get older.
All right, Grandad. Mr. Reiser.
Hello, Sean. You still keeping fit?
Yeah, hard work, but it's worth it.
Where's your mum?
Well, she's still at work. Yeah, I took the bus to the sports hall.
Oh, so you're all trying a new approach?
Well, we're trying to cut back on petrol.
Indeed we are. I'm going inside now to do some sums. Do you fancy earning a couple of quid?
Sounds good to me.
Give the car a wash, just in case.
Well, in case?
I may be selling it.
Oh, all right. I'll do it now.
All right. See you later.
See you, Alistair.
Gives me a chance to think over my business plans.
Business? I thought you were still at college.
Oh, I am, but I finished my A-levels in a couple of months, and that's when I want to put my business into action.
Oh, it sounds intriguing. Tell me more.
Could we go and see Mr. Reiser after tea?
What on earth for?
We want to ask him a few questions.
I'm sure he's got better things to do than talk to you two.
Oh, thanks. He's a very busy man.
Please. We won't be a nuisance.
Okay. You have to finish all your tea first.
Oh, I am knackered. I missed the rush hour, thank God.
Did you buy us a present, Gran?
Of course I did, my sweet.
And me?
How could I forget my favourite grandson?
Your only grandson.
Doesn't matter, he's still my favourite. Now, I bought you a train, because it's like you. Knows where it's going and always stays on track.
Oh, wow, thanks.
And I bought you a bus because it's like you. Takes care of each person and gets there in the end.
Excellent.
I think this speaks for itself.
A rubbish truck.
I'm off home now.
Okay, have a good weekend.
I'll try. Are you walking to the car park now?
Nah, I've got to finish off here. I'll get a cab later.
You get a cab to the car park?
Yeah, save me legs, I'm exhausted.
All right, fair enough. See you Monday.
Yeah, bye.
So it depends on my exam results, really.
What subjects are you studying? Art, I presume?
Yeah, art, information technology, maths and design.
The perfect combination for a graphic designer.
Yeah, except it's not as easy to set up your own business.
Ah, true. But I did run my own business for over 20 years, and I could let you know some of the pitfalls.
That would be great. Of course, the main problem is the cost of renting an office and the hassle of getting into town every day.
Yeah, but why in town?
Well, I need somewhere to work. I was going to share this car with Grandad, but he's going to sell it.
Yes, but there is a way of killing two birds with one stone.
How do you mean?
Work from home. Set up all the equipment there. Then you won't have to worry about renting and kitting out a new office or travelling to town to reach it. Hello, Jamie and Zoe.
We hope you don't mind, Mr. Reiser.
But we want to ask you a few questions.
Yes, of course. Why don't you come over to my place? I just might have some of my gooseberry and mushroom squash lying around. Huh? See you later, Sean.
Bye.
Oh, yeah, see ya.
Reducing pollutions. What ideas have you come up with?
Walking instead of driving.
Or cycling.
Good.
Yellow lines on the roads by all the schools to stop people from parking.
Excellent.
Hey, what about car sharing?
Yes, we could all go to school in one car.
Indeed. Well done.
Can't you get us out of this traffic, cabbie?
Not unless you want me to drive over the pavement, mate.
Jonathan Pike. Yes. Yes, I know I am late, dear. I also happen to run my own business and work in London, so you'll just have to lump it. Charming. Lost the signal.
Find out if there's a cycle route to the town from here.
Well, first thing to do is buy a bike.
Well, we won't spend the money until we're sure it's a safe option.
Mum?
Yes?
Can I use the study upstairs?
What for?
Well, I've got an idea for what to do when I finish my exams.
Good grief.
What's the matter, Grandad?
Do you realise that I have spent in the last year £1,134 on keeping that car on the road?
What?
Blimey, you can get a cab everywhere for a quarter of that.
I'm astounded. Puts a whole new light on keeping the car.
You all right, mate?
Yeah. Just get me to the car park.
Oh, I can't. It's locked solid. Some idiot's parked in the middle of the junction.
Get me out of here.
Oh, I can't. I'm stuck between two cars.
No! Oh! Oh, my chest! My chest!
Mum, Dad!
We've worked out some ways to cut pollution.
Sorry?
Then people won't have a go at you in the street.
What are you two talking about?
Oh, I've been picking a fight with the neighbours, eh?
Certainly not.
This woman had a go at Mum for speeding and polluting the air.
Ah, brought it like a fish off, eh? You are lowering the tone of the neighbourhood.
I would never be seen...
All right. Mum. So what are your plans, then?
I'll get it.
Fingers crossed it's the decorators saying they've finished. I wanted to leave.
You going to listen to our plans?
Yeah, go on, son.
We've worked out a brilliant way to get rid of loads of traffic.
And that is?
Car sharing.
With whom?
The parents take it in turns to drive us kids to school.
Don't be silly.
Why's that silly? Because...
Because your mum is this way.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Now what's wrong?
It's your boss, that Jonathan Pike bloke. That was his brother on the phone.
What's happened?
He's had a heart attack.
What?
Well, how is he?
Yeah, it's all set up.
Just going over the road to Laura's. I'll get it.
Right.
Hello. Angela's here for you, Dad.
Okay, just coming down.
Bye, Sharon.
Morning, Mr. Isaac. Shall I put the kettle on?
Oh, would you? I'll be down in a minute.
Okay.
Nervous?
Very. I don't know, Grandad. What'll I do?
You'll be fine. Whatever the outcome, you can talk to me.
Thanks.
How are you today?
I'm very well, I think.
Good.
Hiya.
Ah, morning, Paul.
I'll be over in a sec for Laura's meeting, just having a chat with Mr. Reiser.
Okay, Sharon.
Sexy legs.
Oh, cheeky thing.
Is Laura inside?
Yeah, she's got the house back to normal. Then my mum's finally gone.
When was that?
Last week. Laura's over the moon, I can tell you.
Hi, Marina.
Oh, hi.
Surely you're not jogging to the car from the house?
No, I'm going to show Mr. Reiser something, actually.
Ooh, the legs, perhaps.
Ooh, hidden all these years. Paul, do some jogging or cover up those legs. You're upsetting the cat.
Yes, dear.
Come on in, girls. Coffee's hot. Wait.
Morning.
Ah. So, how's the fitness regime?
Oh, it's not bad, actually. I'm walking to the station every day now. I'm jogging at weekends. I'm starting the gym this week as well.
Good for you. So, what happened at work since your boss died 4 months ago?
Yeah, it's a shame, poor Jonathan. His older brother's running the business now.
Oh, well, at least the power struggle is over.
Mm. Yeah, talking of struggles, Mr. Reiser, something I want to show you.
It sounds like a perfect excuse for a pot of my very own raspberry and chocolate tea.
And what's put the frown on your face this morning?
Well, have you seen the news?
Mm, yes, they start on the bypass next week.
What can we do?
Not a lot, actually.
They just won't listen. It's so frustrating. Oh, hello, Sean.
Hello, Mrs. Shawcross.
Oh, do call me Angela.
I'm off now.
Okay, good luck. Don't forget to call.
Good luck.
Yeah, A-level results today.
Oh, try not to worry. I'm sure everything will be fine.
I hope so. See you later.
Bye. Poor boy. The teens are a terrible time.
I'll tell you what, let's go for a really long walk by the river this morning. Get out of the house.
What a good idea. So they're actually going to go ahead with it.
I know. Can you believe it?
A whole new building development on Redmond's Brook.
It's absolutely terrible, Mr. Reiser.
It's a place of outstanding natural beauty. That's what they called it.
I know. And all those new roads to be built as well.
Indeed, as if the roads aren't choked enough in the morning with everyone trying to get to the station.
The town's going to come to a complete standstill if there's any more cars.
I know. However, there is one solution to the car problem.
There is?
Oh, yes, and we must keep up public pressure to ensure that it does happen.
So, what is it then?
Proposed plans for a new rail platform just south of the new development on Redmond's Brook.
What, a whole new train stop?
On the existing main line, thus preventing everyone from travelling to our local station.
Yeah. Yeah, perfect.
If it happens. Aye, yeah, yeah. Oh, you finished already. You must really like my tea. Here, have another cup.
Angela and I are just going for a walk.
Okay.
Now, you be careful on your first cycle ride into town.
I will, don't worry.
See you later.
Bye. Here we go.
Right, we're off now, Katie.
Bye, Katie.
And mind how you go on that cycle.
Oh, and stick to the cycle paths.
Okay, have a good walk, you two. Bye.
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 I don't think so.
Mum? Oh, great, she's already gone.
Do you think they'll go for it?
I hope so. We've got to do something.
So how are you finding it here?
Quiet, but very nice. Still, I had come down to see Laura before, so I knew what it was like.
How's Antonia?
She still has the asthma, but the attacks happens less. Now it's just hay fever I worry about.
I'm pleased she and Katie seem to be getting on.
Yeah, that always is the worry, where the kids will settle in the new town.
So, what was it you wanted to talk about? Something these two said about 4 months ago. Well, before you moved here.
Oh, what was that?
We've been on an anti-pollution crusade.
Good for you.
Katie's just got her new bike and is cycling into town today, so she's doing her bit for the environment.
So, what's this got to do with us?
We think you should all do a car share for school.
You mean we take it in turns to drive all the kids?
Yes. Well, I can't give up my car, I need it for the tennis club. Well, it's pointless to walk them all the way there and then come all the way back just to drive past the school.
It should give you some extra free time in the mornings.
Well, that's always welcome.
And Mr. Johnson, who lives three doors down, also wants to be in on it.
He can't be here today because they've gone on holiday.
He told us he would like to take us on Wednesdays, because that's the day he doesn't work.
Great. Well, I'll do Fridays, as I can drive straight to my parents afterwards.
I'll do Thursday, and I'll do Mondays.
And what about the Tuesday?
Why don't you take it in turns to do it? Then you'd only do one Tuesday in every four.
Perfect. Saving time and petrol.
And keeping the kids happy too. Are you both happy?
Yep.
We're happy.
Now, go off and play.
Could we go and see Mr. Riser?
As long as you don't bother the poor man.
The only one needs help with our project.
Okay. But be careful when you're crossing the road. I'll be watching.
So, you agree to let Katie cycle into town?
As long as she was sensible, yes.
Great. Well, she and Antonio can cycle together.
To?
I'm going into town to meet Natalie and Sarah.
Oh, right. Where's your cycle helmet?
It looked naff on me, so I left it at home.
You should wear one. Everyone does nowadays.
Yeah, but it'll spoil my hair.
It's better your hair spoilt than your head crushed like an egg.
Oh, Antonia!
It's true. This boy where I used to live got his head splattered all over the pavement. He was talking on his phone and riding at the same time, lost his balance and fell off. It was gross.
Yeah, well, I'll be concentrating.
If your mum catches you, she'll never let you ride into town again.
I've hidden it so she won't know.
Believe me, if she's anything like my mum, she'll know.
You're making me paranoid.
You spent weeks convincing her to let you go. Now you're going to just throw it away. What if you're grounded? What am I going to do?
Stop worrying.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Okay, okay. Look, do you want to come in mine for tea afterwards?
Yeah, great. Knock for me when you come back from town.
Sure, see you later.
Bye.
Ah, my very special homemade peanut and cherry cookies for the kindle.
Right, you two. Behave yourselves to Mr. Riser.
Yes, Dad.
They will be fine. I can show them my solar spiders. Now, off you go and keep fit.
All right, see you later.
Bye.
Mm,
So, the grown-ups are finally doing your car share idea.
Yep, they're having a meeting now.
There's four of them involved. They're working out a rota.
Oh, excellent. Well done. If you don't watch out, you'll be recruited by Angela Shawcross and her environmental team.
Can you help us with our summer project?
It's about the environment.
Oh, of course. What do you want?
Well, we've got to find some proof that our world's changing because of the way that we live.
And it has to be local proof.
Difficult, but not impossible. Got it. Follow me.
This is beautiful.
Oh, isn't it? Away from the hustle and bustle of everything.
I think I've made a decision about my car.
Oh, good. It's only taken you 4 months.
Well, it hasn't been easy making up my mind.
So? What are you going to do, keep it or sell it?
Well, before I tell you that, I'd like to say one thing. You're a very wonderful person, and you've made me extremely happy in the 4 months that I've known you.
Does this mean that we're going out?
You know, I think it does.
There we are. What can you see in the puddle?
Oil.
And grit. And muck.
Doing? We're finding proof of the way we're destroying our own environment.
Hey, let's take a photo of this dirty puddle.
You should have seen the street we lived in.
In town, wasn't it?
Yeah, the walls of the houses were filthy, the roads were unsafe, and the poor trees were trapped in the pavement. Looked so sad and brown. Their leaves were coated in dirt from the traffic.
What, worse than round here?
This is paradise in comparison.
That's it.
What?
That could be the subject of your topic. Antonio's comparison of living near a town to living near the countryside.
Perfect.
Hey, we could interview you.
Let's walk home and we can discuss this over a cup of my most delicious baked bean and lemon soup.
What?
Joke.
An effective little rotor, if I say so myself. It's nice to see the kids caring.
Well, it's them that's going to live in the world we're making now.
I'll drop a copy off at the Johnsons when they get back from holiday.
Okay.
Oh, excuse me.
They're like a plum tree with no fruit. Let me in.
In? Why have you got all these bags?
The idiots that live in the flat above let their bath overrun. The ceiling's collapsed. My front room and my bedroom are ruined.
So? Why are you here?
I've come to stay till the builders get it fixed. Is that lunch I smell?
Pam, I've got friends here. You can't go in dressed like that.
Well... That was a lovely walk.
Yes.
What's the matter?
Just thinking about the car again.
Not again. Do you always dither this much?
Should have seen me when my late wife proposed to me.
She proposed?
Took me 6 months to make up my mind.
Oh, Alistair, I don't wish to alarm you, but your tax disc is out of date.
What? Oh, Lord. Oh, I completely forgot. I'm breaking the law.
Don't
Apparently, I'll be sent to prison. Oh, my dear, good heavens, if it isn't one thing, it's another.
Alistair, calm down. All we have to do is go to the post office today and renew it. Now, where are the forms?
Oh, inside, by the fridge. Oh, how could I have been so silly? How could I have forgotten?
Calm down. Just go inside and get them, and I'll meet you outside the front door.
Oh, would you? You're so kind and thoughtful.
Up or the post office will be closed. Alistair! Paul, could you give us a lift to the post office, please? Paul? Where's he going at such high speed? He'll kill someone!
Oh, sorry, Angela.
How odd.
What?
I just thought I saw you driving off at high speed. Oh, it must have been your wife.
Laura's not sure to drive me. Oh, no. I left my keys in it.
What?
Someone's hit the car off my drive. Go and tell Laura, please. Yeah. Oi, you! Hey!
Alistair!
Angela? Alistair. Yes, I'm on my way, Angela. I'm on my way. What's the matter?
Alistair!
What is it, Angela?
Oh, a bit of a disaster. Paul's had his car stolen off his very own driveway.
What? This day's rapidly becoming a nightmare.
Well, he's just run after the thief.
That's a bit dangerous.
Look, you go in and phone the police, and I'll go and tell Laura.
Right.
I see you still make tea like dishwater.
So, you're Paul's mum.
Yeah. Aren't you the one whose husband ran off with that woman from Plaster?
Do you remember me, Pam?
Yeah. Stroppy little madam, always moaning about something or other.
So, how long's it going to take to get your flat repaired?
I don't know. I might be here weeks.
Oh, Angela!
Oh, sorry to burst in like this, but the door was open.
Oh, what's the matter?
Don't tell me you've discovered running makes you look younger.
You'll need to get a head start then, won't you?
Are you okay?
Bad news, I'm afraid.
What, twice in one day? It's not Dad. Is he okay?
No, he's fine. It's your husband. His car's been stolen.
What?
Oh, my yes. Poor little boy.
Oh, don't get me, poor little boy.
It's your fault.
Oh, dear. I don't know where these keys are. Gracious me, where are they? Oh, dear.
Alistair? You look in a terrible state.
Oh, disaster.
Mr. Singleton, are you okay?
Tragedy. Look, you've got to help me.
What's happened?
Well, I've just locked myself out and I've got to phone the police.
The police?
What for?
Your dad's car's been stolen.
Where's Paul? We went after them.
He's such a brave lad.
Look.
The police.
That was quick. A little too quick. The police. What are you doing?
Are you in trouble?
I think they've come to arrest me.
Why?
I haven't paid my car tax.
They wouldn't arrest you for that.
So why have they come?